The United States was the first country to make nuclear weapons, and they remain the only country to have ever used them in combat. This was in 1945 at Hiroshima and Nagasaki, Japan. Right now, the US has 4,018 nuclear weapons. These are stored all around the world. They're mainly in the USA, but they're also in Europe and Turkey too. They can be triggered by the president using the also illustrious nuclear codes. But what a lot of people don't realize is it's more the nuclear briefcase, aka nuclear football, that does this. Today we're going to look at what this nuclear football actually is, how it works, and how it could destroy the world. I'm Charlie, and today we're going to look at how a nuclear code's transported. But before we get into it, subscribe and press the notification bell too. So we already know the USA has lots of nukes. They have the second most after Russia, which has over 6,000. But unlike what Kim Jong-un and Trump may say on Twitter, it's not a big red button on their desk that can trigger these nukes. Instead, all of that power is located in a nuclear suitcase. This is known as the Presidential Nuclear Football. This is carried everywhere the president goes to any country. An aide will carry this on the president's plane and in any helicopter the president goes in as well. The briefcase is a metal Zero Halliburton briefcase, the strongest in the world. It weighs 20 kilograms and is carried by an aide of the president. The name football from nuclear football comes from the war plan codename Dropkick. This was an early nuclear war plan back in the Cold War days. Inside it, there are four key things. One is a manila folder. Inside it will be the procedures for an emergency broadcast system. This is basically a scary broadcast they play on TV saying that nuclear war is going on. Every TV in the country will be interrupted to play this message. The second thing inside the briefcase is a black book. This contains a menu of sorts of pre-planned strike options. These are different strike options as to where the missiles could hit and the damage they will do. The third thing is another black book of classified sites. This is a list of bunkers where the president can be sheltered. No one knows where these bunkers are, but they're likely in secured locations. They may be in a foreign country, or perhaps carved into a cliff somewhere like the president of Russia, Vladimir Putin, has. And the fourth thing inside is the nuclear biscuit. The nuclear biscuit is a plastic card with authentication codes. These are the actual nuclear codes you always hear people talking about. Obviously, nobody knows what they are, but they're thought to be a string of numbers 6 to 12 long. In the USA, we've never actually seen what's inside Trump's nuclear suitcase. But Russian TV actually did show a rare glimpse of one of Putin's nuclear briefcases. Zvezda, a TV station run by Russia's Ministry of Defense, was permitted to open one up live on TV. There's also a keypad, a big red button like you see in the movies, and various other glowing buttons. So if the president decided to go nuclear, this is what he'd see. But how would that operation actually carry out? What if the president of the USA suddenly decided it was time for nuclear war? Well, the operation would go like this. First off, the president would be taken aside by the carrier and the briefcase would be opened. The carrier is the person who carries around the briefcase. This is usually someone from the National Military Command Center of the Pentagon. Attack options would then be reviewed with a military aide. The plan could involve firing as many as 925 nuclear bombs. This would be the equivalent of 17,000 Hiroshimas. To put that into perspective, it would pretty much wipe out the entire of the USA, Russia, or China. Next, the president would be positively identified using the biscuit. Under the two-man rule, the defense secretary is required to verify the order. But they have no authority to veto the decision. This means if the president wanted to and had the biscuit, aka nuclear codes, he could start nuclear war. Once these codes have been verified, the military issues attack orders to the proper units. These orders will then be re-verified for authenticity. The missiles would then be fired, and the world would change forever. Once the missiles are fired, they can't be called back or disarmed. The US president has the sole authority to launch a nuclear attack, which is pretty scary. Or not so scary, depending on how much you trust the president at any given time. In many current press images with President Trump, you can see the nuclear briefcase in the background. That's because an aide always has to have it nearby in case nuclear war kicks off. Remember, this wouldn't just be used to initiate nuclear war. It could also be a response to nuclear war if a country like Russia, China, or North Korea launches a nuke at the USA. In 2018, there was even a dust-up with Chinese officials because of Trump's nuclear football. The aide who was carrying the nuclear football was not allowed into the Great Hall by the Chinese security. Chief of Staff John Kelly then said, "We're going in," and went in anyway. But then a Chinese security official grabbed Kelly, who shoved the man's hand away. The Chinese official was then tackled by the Secret Service. Thankfully, the international incident was quickly quelled and everyone apologized. But it just goes to show the power of the nuclear suitcase. Recently, a guest at Trump's Mar-a-Lago also posted photos identifying the carrier of the nuclear football. One Florida man named Richard was invited to Trump's Mar-a-Lago estate. He later posted on Facebook saying, "This is Rick, he carries the football." At first, some thought he had broken the law by identifying this person. But later on, the Department of Defense said this is not illegal, but it is strange. So now we know how nuclear codes are transported around the world. And it's worth noting that every country with nukes will also have this same procedure. This includes Russia, France, China, the UK, Pakistan, India, Israel, and North Korea. But now it's time to make your voice heard. Vote in the poll in the top right corner. Do you think we'll ever have nuclear war? If you want some more amazing videos, then check out my second channel. But as always, thank you for watching. There's some more videos you may like on screen right now. Leave a like if you enjoyed, and if you haven't already, what are you waiting for? Subscribe to Top 10s.